lone ranger minding the willow. He and his wife once lived happily, planted a seed that grew through the reeds. Summers and winters through snowy Decembers, sat by the water close to the embers, missing out the lives that they once had before. I wouldn't leave you, I would hold you when the last day comes. What if you need me? Won't you hold me on the last day, our last day? Mr. and Mrs. spoken, love would return, spoken inside, too soft to be heard. Summers and winters through snowy Decembers, sat by the water, remembering embers, missing out the lives that they once had.
That's not yet. We have been invited by Kristen and David to join with them on this special occasion, their wedding day. Thank you for not only coming today, but for the role you have played in their lives up to this point. Do you, Dwight, Mary Beth, Peter, and Nanette, as the parents of Kristen and David, give your blessing and pledge your support to them as they take this step of uniting as husband and wife? If so, respond, we do. As extended family and friends, you have been invited here to witness that which will unfold here this afternoon. And so what I would ask all of you, do you give your blessing and pledge your support to Kristen and David as they take this step of uniting as husband and wife? If so, respond, we do.
Amen.
Parents and guests may be seated because you got the right answer. Kristen and David, today you are surrounded by those who love you and who support you in this step that you are taking in your relationship today. Although this is a serious and significant step, I want the two of you to relax and enjoy this moment in time. Before we continue, do either of you know of any reason why you may not be joined in marriage at this time? Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Do you, David Lomas, after careful consideration, affirm that it is your desire and intent to take Kristen Millett to be your wife? If so, respond, I do.
I do.
And do you, Kristen Millett, after careful consideration, affirm that it is your desire and intent to take David Lomas to be your husband? If so, respond, I do.
I do.
Letter H stands for the word honor. Honor the vows that you are going to make to each other, but more importantly, honor each other with words and with actions. The letter A stands for the word appreciate. Appreciate those qualities and reasons that drew the two of you together, especially those things that your partner does for you, and don't take them for granted. Appreciate the special moments in life, such as this one, that the two of you have shared and will yet share in the days to come. The letter N stands for the word nurture. Nurture your relationship so that it will continue to grow and be healthy. This takes both time and energy from each of you. One cannot grow this relationship alone. Make time for each other and keep your relationship vital and dynamic. The letter D stands for the word destination. In a way, today is a destination point in your relationship journey. The two of you have selected this time and place and have worked to achieve this end. Now you set out from here to reach another destination, a destination that you mutually agree upon and to which you journey together. A journey to a faraway destination is, however, made up of reaching destinations all along the way. I would exhort you to stay focused, stay together, encourage each other, enjoy each other. Don't be so fixated on the destination that you miss out on all that the journey to that destination has to offer you. The final letter stands for the word supports. As you journey on from here, be mindful of the supports that are available to you. There are your parents. You have heard them publicly declare their support for you. Learn from them. Seek their advice. But a reminder to you parents, although they may seek your advice, that in no wise obligates them to follow it. And don't give it unless they ask for it. You have also heard your extended family and friends declare their support for you today. Utilize this support system. As family and friends, love Kristen and David enough to remind them of the vows that they will share in just a moment. Give them the time and space they need to focus on their relationship. And if need be, challenge them if you notice that things are starting to unravel. Many times I have shared with you that I do not just do weddings, but I perform marriages. And as such, I am also available should you need support along the journey that you are embarking upon. As great as these supports are, the best support you have should be the one whose hands you are holding today. Listen to these words penned by an unknown author in a piece entitled, The One. When the one whose hands you're holding is the one who holds your heart, when the one whose eyes you gaze into gives your hope and dreams their start, when the one you think of first and last is the one who holds you tight, and the things you plan together make the whole world seem just right. When the one whom you believe in puts their faith and trust in you, you found the one and only love you'll share your whole life through. With these thoughts in mind, I would now invite you to share your vows with each other.
I, David Victor Lomas, take Kristen Lorelei Millett to be my best friend, my teammate, and my one true love. I promise to encourage you, inspire you, and support you through good times and bad. I will forever be there to laugh with you, lift you up when you are down, and love you unconditionally through all of our adventures. I promise to only go fishing 3 days a week. Just kidding. I promise to you, no matter where we are in life, I will grow with you, and as long as we have each other, we can achieve anything. I will forever be your friend.
I, Kristen Lorelei Millett, take you, David Victor Lomas, to be my best friend, my teammate, and my one true love. I promise to encourage you, inspire you, and support you through good times and bad. I will forever be there to laugh with you, lift you up when you are down, and love you unconditionally through all of our adventures. I promise to you, no matter where we are in life, I will grow with you. As long as we have each other, we can achieve anything. I will forever be your one.
May these rings act as a seal authenticating and confirming that which you have promised to each other here today. David, do you give Kristen this ring as a seal to your vows and a symbol of your love?
I do.
Kristen, do you receive this ring as a seal of David's vows and as a symbol of his love?
I do.
Kristen, do you give David this ring as a seal to your vows and as a symbol of your love?
I do.
David, do you receive this ring as a seal of Kristen's vows and a symbol of her love?
I do.
For as much as you, David Lomas, and you, Kristen Millett, have declared publicly your desire to be joined in marriage, and have exchanged your vows before those of us gathered here, by the authority granted to me by the Marriage Act of Ontario, I now declare you to be husband and wife, and I would invite you to share your first kiss as such.
Side. Then we grew a little and romanticized the time I saw flowers in your hair. See, it takes a boy to live, it takes a man to pretend he was there. So then we grew a little and knew a lot, and now we demonstrated it to the cops and all the things we said. We were self-assured. 'Cause it's a long road to wisdom, but it's a short one to being ignored. Be in my eyes, be in my heart, be in my eyes, I, be in my heart. Compromise.
Dave and Kristen united today in marriage. We are so thrilled to be a part of this magnificent day and celebration in this gorgeous Parry Sound. Thank you, Lord, for guiding their footsteps toward each other. Thank you for allowing us to be with them as they pledge their love and life to each other. Lord, we ask you to fill their fishing nets with lots of smiles, lots of laughter, lots of joys, lots of celebrations. May their life be filled with abundant blessings as they learn to walk, run, even skate with each other and with you. And we give thanks for all the blessings that are before us this evening as we share them together.
Amen. David, thank you for the path you set for your brothers. You made our life a lot easier. Amen. As a lucky guy to have three sons who I would call my three best friends is crazy.
Try not to do the past face.
Okay, on a lighter note, Kristen, your vision and all the people that contributed to this venue, incredible. It was a lot of work, a lot of planning. It was worth it. I thank you for that. You want to speak now?
No. From the moment our Nova Scotia girl arrived in Ontario, she opened her heart and took all of Dave's family in as her own. My mother of three boys wouldn't love a girl who asked to borrow her hair dryer. I can tell you, it was a first for me. I was so excited to be sharing with another female in the house, not to mention, it was the very first time in 25 years that somebody other than my boys had borrowed my hair dryer to curb the blade of a hot knife. Kristen, you have been family from the moment Dave brought you home, and now it's official. We love you, Kristen.
Especially those who have traveled outside the province and the country. Many of you knew that we'd be speaking and still decided to come, so a special thanks to you for coming. For those of you who are not familiar with who we are, we are Dave's younger brothers, Mike and Dan. I am the forgotten middle one, while Dan is and will forever be Mama's poor little baby.
I guess that's his point of view. You can consider us the artist masterpiece, while Dave is definitely the rough sketch. Rough being the operative word there. But on a serious note, we're honored to stand up here in front of you and be a part of such a special day. Kristen, you look absolutely stunning. It's bizarre to admit it, but I'm extremely excited to have a sister. And the look in Dave's eyes when you walked down the aisle was something I don't think either of us will ever forget. And I think it sums up your love perfectly. Dave, I think all of us need to thank you for ditching the Crocs and Camel today. Kristen, he must really love you.
what a privilege it is to be Dave's best man. That being said, we've always been, I guess, the best, but that's a whole other story. With the best man becomes, there's actually comes with several, a couple important duties, like,
I think the first one is try our best, and we do might mean our best to not look better than him on his special day.
Second, given his horrible fashion sense, making sure Kristen does like the ties we pick out.
Good one.
And third is making sure he's off the water long enough to actually be in attendance.
And then last but definitely not least, making sure his hair and his face are in order.
At least we got three of the four.
We know how most best men speeches go, so we'll bring you back to the beginning. We obviously both met Dave when we were born. Truth be told, Dave hated us when we came along. Apparently we were the reason he never got a cottage or a boat.
But then again, who would he have taught to rig a lure, unhook a fish, or use for target practice in the backyard? You're welcome.
In the early years, Dave and I were quite the tag team of picking on Dan. Like when I would pin Dan down and Dave would tickle him till he pissed himself.
Now that everybody knows that. Or when you decided to convince me to stick candies up my nose, resulting in a quick trip to the emergency room. Or when you both double bounced me so high on the trampoline I broke my wrist when I came down.
Like I said, quite the tag team. I feel like I can speak for both of us when I say growing up, we always looked up to Dave. He was always the first to do things, play both junior hockey and lacrosse, get a car, buy a house, be a dog owner, you know, the cool stuff.
On the other hand, he was also the first to gain weight and adopt our father's hairstyle. So I guess when you look at it that way, there's pluses and minuses.
Dave always led by example and showed us what it took to achieve certain goals in life, and having that at our disposal was invaluable.
Still to this day, the night before I have a big game, Dave's the first one to text me with his words of wisdom and exactly what I should be doing when I go out there, and that's something that it's hard to put into words exactly what that means to me, but it kind of gives me the confidence and the will to do everything he'd done in his athletic career and obviously business career as well, and in order to follow in his successful footsteps. So thank you for that.
Now personally, moving away from friends and family at the age of 16 is no easy task. But having the opportunity to talk to someone that you can relate to is something I still cherish to this day. He's always been there to offer advice and offer a new perspective in life. It did not matter how far we were apart. He was always willing to take the time to talk. Who knows where I'd be today if it was not for him. I cannot continue to thank him enough for what he's done for me and will continue to do. He has paved a path that I continue to follow still to this day.
Once again. On the other hand, he showed us what not to do. Like convince all the other kids to take their clothes off on the playground, causing him to have to go to sexual therapy. Yeah, that wasn't recently, don't worry.
Or eat a full box of Kleenex, including the box, causing what? The Danny to run out of our house quitting, saying that he is possessed. Thank you.
Dave and Kristen both attended a Canadian university in Nova Scotia. Dave playing hockey and Kristen playing soccer. They met at the annual men's hockey pub crawl, where the girls drew straws to find out who their partner in crime would be for the night. Kristen obviously drawing the short straw. Had to deal with Dave's smooth lines for the entire night.
This would be the night where Dave would get used to the word no coming out of Kristen's mouth. From then on, they bounced from city to city, province to province, and country to country.
I'm sure against much of the will of Kristen's family, they have decided to hang their hat where we find ourselves today. That being said, we would like to take a moment to thank Kristen's family for supporting her move out west.
You've given us a caring, loving, yet sometimes overprotective sister that we never had. The way she helps older adults stay healthy through exercise is just one other example of her selflessness. Maybe you could try expanding your demographic into 30-year-old retired male athletes, but that's beside the point.
Nevertheless, we welcome into the family with open arms, just as long as she keeps the dulse out of nose reach. Mom and Dad, you must be so proud of the man you have raised. Your hard work and dedication has paid off and brought an amazing woman into our lives.
How you guys did what you did to raise all three of us is something we can never understand or fully appreciate, but special moments like this are a testament to your guys' hard work, and enjoy today as this is something you'll cherish for the rest of your lives. At this time, we would like everyone to raise their glass. Dave, as we all know, has had very memorable catches in his life, but I think we can all agree that his best catch is sitting right beside us.
We wish you nothing but the best and are excited for what's ahead. Here's the beginning of another chapter of the lives of Kristen and Dave. Cheers to Mr. and Mrs. Lomas.
That was one of the better speeches I've ever.
Thank you very much.
Through the times of tests, it has become clear that Dave and Kristen are one. They belong together, and I am so proud of both of you for what you've accomplished and the hurdles you've come across. It hasn't been easy. You've had all kinds of ups and downs, but you have mastered that. So your life together, I wish you all the best. I love Dave. I love you like a son that I do not have. So this is new to me, and Kristen, I love you to the moon and back, but always and forever. So to my girls, and to Kristen and Dave. But
And then last but not least, with my new husband, David. He's been so supportive to me, and I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for you. I love you so much, and that's it. I love you, and yeah, I'm so excited to share the many years with you, and so, but thank you very much, everybody, and that's it.
Strong and use my head alongside my heart, so tame my flesh and fix my eyes, a tethered mind freed from the light.
When the last day comes, I wouldn't leave.